I hope you come to worship God. Let's all stand to our feet. Take up our Sunday morning tithe and offering. We ask the ushers to come. Say the blessing, please, home. My hope is in the blood. Every hope that I have here in this old sinful world is anchored in the blood of the Lamb. Though the billows are raging and we're tossed to and fro, there is peace beneath His blood. And my hope of the precious Lamb of God, there is no other fountain so sweet. For it has washed away my sin, gave me peace and joy within. My hope is anchored in His blood. Now only one thing will matter when my time shall come to go. The treasures of this world won't mean a thing. Oh, but the joy of knowing Jesus will banish all my fears. For He took away death's sting, and my hope of the precious Lamb of God, there is no other fountain so sweet. For it has washed away my sin, gave me peace and joy within. My hope is anchored in His blood. Hallelujah. Amen. I appreciate His blood and what it's done in my life. Amen. You may be seated. Good to see you in the Lord's house today. Amen. Hope you come to worship God. He's worthy. If ever be it, He's due all of our honor and all of our praise. Amen. So whether you feel like it or not, it won't hurt you a bit. Just raise your hands every once in a while and say, praise the Lord. Amen. You say, I want to feel something before I do. Amen. I'll tell you what He felt when He done what He done so you could have it. He felt pain. Amen. I was thinking coming down the road, Taylor, when I was in school, I'd done a lot of stupid things to be people's friends. I just wanted to fit in. Wanted to be in a clique. You know how it goes? The cool kids, whatever they did, I wanted to do to be cool. Let me tell you what Jesus did, just to be your friend. He died for you. Amen. Amen. Just so He could be your friend. Amen. I mean, somebody that just wanted to welcome you in and save you from your sin and just wanted to walk with you and just be friends with you and be able to talk with you. He died for you. Amen. So He paid a high price just to be your friend. Can I say, Lord, He's my best friend. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm glad this morning to know I'm in His family. He's my friend. He's my best friend. He's done a lot for me, and I appreciate all He's done for me. Amen. Morgan, come sing for us this morning. Amen. Let's just worship the Lord.
righteous man suffer pain. It looked like the wicked would go free. In my frustration, it just didn't seem right to me. I ask you for sunshine, but you send rain. I cried for healing, but I only got pain. But I know your love will see me through. Oh Lord, I still trust you. I still trust you, Lord.
Well, I'm glad we can trust the Lord. Amen. I love Him, don't y'all? If you have your Bibles, turn with me to the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah, it's good to see you in the Lord's house this morning. I do desire your prayers this morning that God would help us just a little bit. Amen. I'm really nervous. The Lord gave me this message yesterday, and I feel like these people here this morning, that's your heart is not where it needs to be. And I pray that God will help us through the message. Amen. I want you to know, the Lord wanted me to tell you, I don't want to be a striker. In my younger ministry, it's easy if somebody does you wrong. It's easy if they're in the building to strike at them. But I'm not going to be a striker this morning. And the Holy Ghost wanted me to tell you, I was standing at the sink this morning worrying over this message. And he wanted me to tell you, I'm not throwing nothing at you. I'm going to hand it to you through the Holy Ghost, if he'll help me just a few minutes. Probably some of you, it's not going to be real easy. Amen. I don't want to preach it no more than you probably want to hear it. But I want you to know this morning, you better take it. Amen. Or you're going to be in trouble in just a few days. Jeremiah chapter number 15. And then Hebrews chapter number 10. Amen. Please pray for me. I've never done this before, but will everybody just stretch your hands toward me this morning and pray for me? I need a touch from the Lord. Jeremiah chapter 15, verse number 6. When you find that, say amen. 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 Thou hast forsaken me, saith the Lord. Thou art gone backward. Therefore will I stretch out my hand against thee and destroy thee. I am weary with repenting. Hebrews chapter number 10. When you find that, say amen. Amen. Verse number 26. For if we sin willfully, after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remaineth no more sacrifice for sins, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. He that despised Moses' law died without mercy under two or three witnesses. Of how much sore punishment, suppose ye, should he thought worthy, who hath trodden under foot the Son of God, and hath counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing, and hath done despite unto the Spirit of grace. For we know him that hath said, vengeance belongeth unto me, I will recompense, saith the Lord. And again, the Lord shall judge his people. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of a living God. You may be seated. It is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. It didn't say a living God, it said the living God. Amen. It don't matter what you worship, there ain't but one living God. Amen. And he's the one you're going to give an account to on judgment day. Amen. Now pray for me just a few minutes. I want to preach. If God will hit me on footprints in the blood. Footprints in the blood. Now, amen. I read to you in the book of Jeremiah. And I thought, if I'd have thought about it, I'd have brought a basketball or some kind of ball or something that we play games with. And amen. But as I want you to know this morning, as little as we think that God ain't got no sense, God knows everything, by the way. And as little as you think that you're doing whatever it is you're doing, amen, you're going to get away with it. Can I tell you this morning, God does not play games. Amen. Amen. You don't matter what you think. Amen. Or what some failure has told you. Amen. From behind the pulpit and that calls himself a preacher. Amen. To tell you if you'll just come to church and come and pray. And amen. Just come every once in a while. And whenever the offering plate goes by, put your money in and everything's going to be all right. Amen. But can I tell you, I guess I'm kind of different now. I know I am, but I'm going to tell you, whenever Jesus Christ saves you, amen, he changes your whole life. Amen. You're not who you used to be. Amen. He bought you with a special price. He paid his blood. He gave everything he had. Amen. The Bible said heaven was searched. The earth was searched. Beneath the earth was searched. And nobody was found worthy. And God sending his son in the likeness of sinful flesh. Amen. We was a bunch of no count, no good, nothing. But God so loved the world. Amen. I feel his Holy Ghost this morning. That he gave his only begotten son. It wasn't an easy price to pay. Amen. He gave. He went to Calvary. Amen. He felt every stripe that hit his back. Amen. He knew he was going to need a healing. Amen. They spit in his face and jerked his beard out. Can I tell you, he paid a great price for you. He put a crown of thorns on his head and smote him over the head with a reed. Can I tell you, he loved you enough and to pay that price for you. Can I tell you, he laid them hands down and they drove that nail in his head. Can I tell you, he loved you enough, amen, to come for you. He loved you, hallelujah, and he paid the ultimate price so you wouldn't have to go to hell. Hallelujah. Amen. He gave his life. Come here, Malachi. I mean Jeremiah. I can't tell you how much I love this little fella. Come here, Malachi. I don't want him to feel left out. My girls is old enough to know they are not. I can't tell you how much I love these boys. Brother Johnny, to hear him holler, Malachi hollers of a morning, Daddy, come get me. Just walk with me, son. You know how good it makes me feel to go in there and throw them covers back and put his arms around me and get up in my arms and pat me on the back. Said, I love you, Dad. Yeah. Yesterday morning, he said, how come sometimes you leave, go to work before I get up? Because I miss you when you're not here. Oh, when I go home of the evening, he runs out the door, comes down through the yard, jumps up in my arms. I love him. To watch him get a piece of wood and throw it in the wheelbar. Me mashing the bars down so he don't get stuck. Oh, how I love him. Whenever I go to his crib of a morning, Bobby would look down in there and see him kick and smile at me. Oh, I'd give my life to keep your hands off of my children. If there's somebody come to my door, amen, with a gun, Brother Tom, I'd quickly stand right in front of that gun barrel and said, honey, you get the kids and get out of here. I'll give my life. Oh, but come on, son. Let me tell you what God did. Amen. You know what he did? Amen. He turned the briar loose and let it catch his son. You know what he did? Amen. He let the whole world. And Jesus stood in front of the barrel and said, go ahead and take my life because I want all them heathens to go free. Amen. Go ahead and take my life. Amen. Because there's going to be drunkards and whores and whoremongers. Hallelujah. He took all them stripes. I said he took every one of them. Amen. Some of you was way down there in sin. You know what it was to be hooked on drugs. But Jesus said, I'm going to die for you. Hallelujah. Amen. There ain't nothing else can set you free except lest I die on the cross. Hallelujah. If you're saved this morning, you ought to raise your hands and say, I'm so glad that my Savior went all the way because nothing else has worked, but Jesus Christ has set me free. Hallelujah. If I gave one of them boys so you could go free. Now I want you to think about something. I'm going to preach right here in just a second. If I gave one of my boys and he was the only way for him to die, for you to go to heaven,
And I gave my son so you wouldn't have to go to hell. And then I watched you about 2 weeks or a month or a year later. Amen. Oh God, I'm going to preach this morning. Help me, Jesus. Help me, Jesus. When the new wears off of your salvation. Amen. And when it comes Sunday night. Amen. You think enough. Amen. Of a ball game. You think enough. Amen. Of a worldly amusement. Amen. To go out there after I give my boy's life. Amen. So you wouldn't have to die and go to hell. And now you don't have been more appreciated than a man in the moon. Can I tell you, we're obligated to be faithful to this man. I said we're obligated to be faithful to this man. Hey, you don't have to beat me over the head and to make me praise him, because you know why? I love him. Hallelujah. It's a joy. I said it's a joy to praise the Lord because of what he's done for me. Now, these times you can't be here. I got enough sense to know that. But if you're not, you want to be. Amen. Do you know what? Preaching on footprints in the blood. Trodden underfoot. The Son of God. You go out here in the world and you do your own thing. And then come in here in the house of God. And got enough audacity to stand in the choir. And raise your hands. And if I could track you back to your pew, you'd have blood underneath your feet, going all the way back to your pew. Hallelujah. Oh yeah. Amen. It's going to get white, quiet, but it don't matter to me. Amen. Your hand, your blood. Amen. I don't want it to be dripping off my hands in judgment. Amen. You may nod your head when I preach against, amen, the ungodly music of this world. Amen. You'll nod your head and say amen. And then go right back out yonder in your car and turn that music on and say, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I don't care what the preacher says. You're a hypocrite. Amen. Did you hear me? If you're going to do it, don't shake your head. Don't say amen. Hey, some of you right now, amen, you'll say amen. When we preach on fornication, amen, you made your trip to the altar and said all is well. But hey, some of you got things you've got planned as soon as we get out of this service today. And you know good and well, amen, that it ain't right. You know good and well that it's sin. Amen, you're walking his blood underneath your feet. Amen, shame on you. I said shame on you. Amen. If you're not going to live right, amen, stay in your pew and don't be a hypocrite. Amen. Amen. We'll sing Jesus Loves Me and then we'll curse. We'll tell ungodly jokes. Amen. Footprints. I wonder, Brother John, could I take my shoe off? Amen. Spiritually speaking, and could you see any blood where I've walked on him this week? Amen. Have I crucified him of flesh? Amen. Have you lived ungodly this week? Woo! Hallelujah. Amen. Holy Ghost, help me now. And can I tell you, you're ahead in the judgment. Wouldn't it be something for God to peek around and say, that blood that you've tracked all the way to judgment is the blood of my son that I give to die for you? Amen. Oh, I want to treat it with love. I want to treat it with care. Amen. I want to live holy and upright. I said I want to live holy and upright. And Jesus is coming and you cannot go with the blood on your feet. Hallelujah. Jeremiah said, Brother Johnny, he said, I'm weary with your repenting. Oh, I thought you're supposed to repent. You do. But I believe God's tired of hearing some of you say, I'm sorry, and never change. Amen. Amen. Make your trip up here. God, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please don't kill me. You sit in this service and you feel the Holy Ghost and that spotlight of heaven turns on you. Amen. You come up here and pray. Amen. You treat the blood like it won't set you free. Can I tell you something right now? The blood, amen, can cleanse you from drugs. The blood, if you're here this morning and God has cleansed you, stand to your feet. Amen. If God's cleansed you, stand to your feet. Amen. Don't you dare tell me that God can't set you free. I said, don't you dare tell me that God can't set you free. You don't need what the world's got. I said you don't need what the world's got. Amen. You're either all in or you're all out. Amen. Don't count the blood and trample it under your feet. Amen. You can be seated. Amen. How precious is the blood to you? Amen. If God could speak to you, He'd say, I know you're tempted. Now, I'm about tarred if you folding in, because my blood's good enough. I'm just using you, okay? My blood's good enough to set you free. And I'm about sick and tired, amen, of every Sunday. Amen, you raising your hand and walking a trip down here and wasting the time. Oh, God, help me. Amen, people gather around you. We want you to do good, but we can't set you free. Amen, Jesus can set you free, but you have got to make up in your mind when that temptation comes and to turn and take that way of escape. The blood of Jesus can and will set you free, but can I tell you, you can't trample it under your feet and expect to go to heaven. Amen. Amen. There's some of you. I'm just going as the Holy Ghost leads me. You say, who's been talking to you? You know the one who knows how many hairs is on your head. You say, boy, he ain't got to keep much up with you. You're right, but he knows where every one of them fell out at. A God that knows everything. Hallelujah. I was laying there the other night. Y'all just bear with me. I was laying there the other night listening to my wife breathe. She's got sleep apnea. She goes, she'd turn over a little and I thought, God, please help her to breathe. Do you know, Uncle Bob, when you're sound asleep and don't know you're even in the world, there's a God. There's a God. Oh, Brother Randy, oh, there's a God up in heaven that says, heart beat. Heartbeat. You say, oh no, oh yes, amen. Man can make a lot of things, but it's got to have an extension cord or a battery to operate. But God made man. How said God made man? And he knows how many heartbeats I've got left. I may be up here in a casket before this week ends, but hey, I want you to know if I am, hallelujah, I don't want no blood under my feet. I want it all on my soul, and I want to treat it like I love it instead of taking advantage of it. Amen. As a woman come to the altar one night in a meeting Jason was in, she come up and got on the altar. She stayed and stayed and stayed and stayed and stayed and stayed and stayed. And this old man who was a pastor had a lot of wisdom. Finally, people had to start leaving. I mean, kids. You know how kids are? Just watch them. I mean, if I go over my 20-minute preaching span, they get wild. Y'all don't know how to appreciate a 20-minute preacher, by the way. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Finally, that old man of God said, ma'am, look up here at me. Said, I don't know what it is you're holding on to, but God's not going to dangle it in front of you for no hour. If you're lost and want to get saved and you're under conviction, it don't take all night. What are you holding on to? He said, now these people's needing to go home. You're wasting our time if you're not going to be business with God. That woman looked up to him and said, I love dancing in nightclubs. Said, I know if I get saved, I can't dance in the nightclub. Can I say amen? Amen. He don't save you to turn you back down there in the nightclub. You say, oh, I want to be a witness down there, hogwash. Amen. God will let you be a witness in the middle of the street. He ain't going to send you in no bar room. He ain't going to send you in no dope house. Amen. He saved you from sin. He didn't save you in sin. That's why he said, depart from iniquity. Hallelujah. Because when you do that, you're trodden his blood under your feet. Amen. He said, you're either going to have to get rid of that. You can go dance in the nightclubs if you want to. Die and go to hell. If you're not ready to get rid of it, let's get up. We're ready to go home. Amen. I can baby you and baby you and baby you. Stick pacifiers in your mouth. Amen. If I've got to do all of that to keep you from going to hell, you're really enjoying where you was. I know you may not understand a lot about God, but if he's on the inside of you, hallelujah, he's going to let you know where you was and where you're supposed to be. You're in a brand new family now. You need to act a different way, look a different way, go different places. Because you're a new creature, don't trot his blood under your feet. Amen. Hey, some of you here this morning, you claim to be saved. You still drink alcohol. Hey, some of you here this morning, you claim to be saved, but your nature ain't been changed a bit. Some of you here this morning, you're still using drugs. And the world has told you and sent you through their organizations that says, once you're an alcoholic, you're always an alcoholic. Can I tell you right now that's a lie? Because when he saves you, you're not even that person no more. That person dies. Hallelujah. And resurrected is a brand new creature. I said resurrected is a brand new creature. Hallelujah. Behold, how much? All things. If you is a queer, you get saved, you ain't going to be a queer no more. Amen. You're going to be a Christian. I said you're going to be a Christian. Amen. It don't matter what the world says, Brother Johnny. This is still a holy way. Hallelujah. I wonder how many of you I could track to your seat with blood on your feet. God wanted me to tell you he's about tired of you saying you're sorry and you're never changing. All them Kleenex boxes can be empty every service, and if you're not serious, you're wasting your time. Because you're holding on to the world, but still yet you want God too. Peter never walked on water till he turned loose of the boat. And you'll never have victory in Jesus until you turn loose the world. Worldliness will doom your soul to hell. I talked to a backslid preacher the other day, and this is what he said. He said, I ought to be clawing at the dark halls of hell. I'm talking about backslid, living in sin. You say, once you're saved, you're always saved. You are if you stay in the center of his will. But the one time you think you can go back down yonder and try that garbage you used to try, you're outside of the will of God. Hallelujah. And when he said straight is the gate and narrow is the way, one step out of the way, you're out of the way. You say, I can't live that way. No, you can't by yourself. But as long as you got him by the hand, he said, greater is he that's within me. Did you hear what I said? Greater is he that's within me than he that's within the world. Amen. He walks this way before you. You better stay out of that world. He said, I ought to be clawing at dark sides of hell. But he said, I'm washed in the blood of the Lamb and I'm too wet to burn. footprints in the blood. How many of you could I track with a dirty joke all the way to your pew? And you're claiming to be something. How many of you could I track with curse words? Sorry in a hateful attitude. All the way to your pew. How many of you has got addictions that you buy at the local store when he said he'd set you free? We don't buy Budweiser, but we'll buy enough energy drinks to get the same feeling. Footprints. Oh, Jesus. In the blood. There's some of you here that you say, I don't like that. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Because I want God to have my vessel. Oh, I want God to have my vessel. Oh, when I stand in judgment, I want Him to see that blood applied to my soul and all them sins wiped away. And I don't want them, I don't want the footprints of that darling blood that dripped down from that cross. Amen. Every drop was to wash my sins away. Oh, amen. I don't want, if you can pleasure in sin and still say you're saved, you're not saved. Amen. I'm telling you, sin looks ugly. Sin looks dirty to a blood-washed child of God. You say, have you ever failed? I have. But I'm going to tell you what happens when you fail, when you're saved. The Holy Ghost will say, you should not do that before you do it. And when you go over that and do it anyway, there's such a dirty, nasty feeling that comes over you. What do I do? Instead of walking in that blood, go back to that blood and say, will you please wash me again, Lord? Wash me, Lord. I'm sorry. And if you're really sorry, you have no plans of ever doing it again. Brother Johnny, Brother David, my kids caught on that every once in a while I'd have mercy. So they started saying, I'm sorry, I won't do that no more. Has anybody here ever said that as a child? Sorry, Mom. I'm sorry, Daddy. Won't do it no more. Until the other day, Malachi said, Mom, I'm sorry. She said, sorry's not cutting it no more. It's going to take action more than word. Some of you say a lot of things, but you don't do it. Jesus wanted me to tell you, He's about tired of your repenting. What do I do then? If you don't mean it, don't come. But if you say, I really want to go to heaven. These people in this building right now, Holy Ghost, help me. Give me every word right here. As soon as we dismiss, you're going to go do something and you done got it planned. But in this service, you've sung the songs and raised your hand. Footprints. I wonder if today, wherever it is you're going to do, whatever it is you're going to do, God says, lungs, no more breath. Heart, don't beat no more. And when we get the word that you're gone, where can we track you? You saying you're something that you're not. And there we'll find you, dead in your sin. How many of you lie on a daily basis? Sometimes you wonder why your kids lie. Because they got a great example. Oh God. I love you. Do you know that I can tell my dog I hate it. You're ugly. You got a crooked tail. You ought to be shot. But while I'm saying that, I'm petting it. Every time I say you need to be shot, it'll come up. I want to be petted. Because my actions go with whatever I'm saying. But I can say I love you and kick it. When I holler, I love you, it's going to go the other way. So you can tell your children anything, but it's your actions. Your actions speaks louder than words. You've said you're sorry to God so many times, but in the back of your mind, you had every intention of what's in the back of your refrigerator right now. But if you're really sorry, right now, you're going to go home pour it out. You're going to go throw them dirty CDs away. Them clothes that make you look so ungodly in the world make somebody lust after you. You're going to go home and throw them away.
You're not going to meet that person no more because you know it causes you trouble. You don't want footprints in the blood on judgment. You say, preacher, you're supposed to preach love. I am. Amen. You think that's bad. You wait till you look God in the eye. Let's all stand. Now, I know you can't make it to heaven on your own. He don't expect you to. But there ain't room but for two people on this straight and narrow. You and Jesus. I wonder this morning. You say, preacher, I know I've been playing games. You can take all the spiritual ball goals down in your life because God don't play games. He's an all-business God. And He commands repentance from your heart. If you're here this morning, I just want you to know God sees. God's got your number. And He loved you so much to die for you. But then again, He loved you so much to send a message through me this morning to let you know, get your heart right. Change your actions. Change your plans. Give them to God. Does anybody need to pray? Does anybody need to pray? Footprints. Footprints. Come say, God, I'm sorry. He can wash them footprints clean. So when you walk, you can walk like a righteous man instead of like a hypocrite. There's other people need to pray this morning. There's some of you got footprints. You're claiming to be something and you know you're not. The actions in your life speak so loud that God don't hear words you say. But come this morning and say, I'm tired of the life I'm living. Would you change me? Change me. Who else needs to come? There's others in the church. There's others in the house. Some of you that don't need to pray, would you come work? Just pray around these in the altar. Everybody knows their personal life. Everybody knows their heart. Would you come? Other people need to pray. Other people need to pray. Other people needs to pray. You need to be serious because He's a serious God. He's very jealous. If you're His, man, He's very jealous over what He's done for you, that you wouldn't live sincerely just for Him. Others need to pray. Others is coming. Others is coming. Does anybody else need to pray? Lord, help us. Help us, God. Help us. Help me, please. Help me, please. Please help us, God. Cleanse us from all unrighteousness, God. Help us, please. Help us, Jesus. God, move in our lives. Sanctify us. Clean us. Make us a holy, fit vessel. Please, God. Help us to realize we're going to meet You face to face. Help us, Lord, to have the identity of Your Son when we stand there. I love You, Lord. I love You, Jesus. Move in these altars, please. I don't want to just tell Him I love Him. I want to show Him. And by doing that, he said, if you do love me, keep my commandments. Right here they are. Right here's the roadmap going to heaven. And I'm pretty sure if you'll read it, everything I preached this morning's in there. So he said, he gave a whole list of things and said, I've told you once and I'll tell you again. Those that do such things shall not inherit eternal life. Amen. I want to go to heaven, and I want you to. It's more than just coming to church and paying your tithes. It's a lifestyle. Amen. A lifestyle. Everybody here is making a difference. You're either proving to the world how God can change somebody or proving how much of a hypocrite you are. God help us to be real. Real. Amen. I want something real. Amen. All right. Thank you for being in the Lord's house. Hope you received something from the Word of God. And it's almost over. It's almost over. Amen. You can go just a little piece down the road and find somebody to tell you exactly what you want to hear. It's going to pacify your flesh. But this flesh was not meant to be pacified. It was meant to be crucified. The inward man, if he's going to live, this outward man's got to be crucified every day. Hallelujah. Help us, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, I know when you saved me, you filled me with your Spirit. And I praise your holy name. Oh, precious Lord, to be a light that others see. Your Holy Spirit must be shining in me. Lord, will you empty me of every selfish thing that would hinder my sweet walk with Thee? Shine down upon me and fill me anew in every way, Lord. Let me be more like you. Now when your light, Lord, is shining upon me, well, there's no hiding its wonderful glow. My family and my children, my neighbors and all my friends, when I'm in Jesus, then all others will know. Sing, church. Will you empty me of every selfish thing that would hinder my sweet walk with Thee? And shine down upon me and fill me anew in every way, Lord. Let me be more like you. Hallelujah. You see, whenever the Lord shines His light on you, it's like having an MRI from the Holy Ghost. It's a one-on-one trip. As that light comes on and shines down in your life. So there's a spot. You need to come get that right and get that out of your life. You say, I've read the Bible and I can't find it nowhere. You see, God gives us personal convictions. And if He tells you to quit chewing gum, quit chewing gum. Because down the road somewhere,
it's going to be a fault to you. It's going to be a hindrance to you. So when that Holy Ghost light comes on, you see the flesh wants to get mad when you hear preaching like this. But the inward man says, Lord, empty me, please. If there's anything in there that don't need to be, show me. Be man and woman enough to say, empty me, God, I'm sorry. Wash me with your spirit. Let me be a pure vessel. Lord, looking at this world, it's hard to find a pattern of godliness anymore. But you can find that right there, how you need to live. Live holy, live upright. I love you, church. Hope you know I do. Kids, come on. Let's take up the change this morning. Well, two, three. That it? All right, you know what to do. Everybody stand. Come on, stand up. I'm gonna hurt you. All right, give him a big hand. Birthdays. Who's got a birthday this week? Anybody? Anniversaries? We have some congratulations in order. Kenny and Lisa tied the knot on what day was it? Friday. Let's give him a big hand. Kenny's kind of like me. I'm going to put him on the spot right here. I got so tickled. They sent me the picture of the newlyweds. They had their hands stuck out like this, taking a picture of their hand. Hey, I've been down there. It never quits ringing. Amen. Congratulations. Hallelujah. Live for Jesus. Live for Jesus. Hallelujah. All right. Remember service tonight at 6 o'clock. Come back expecting God to do great things. Maybe the Lord will let us shout tonight. And We'll live by the Bible. We can shout. Is that right?
Amen. There is therefore now no condemnation. Amen. If you're living in Jesus, you don't have nothing to look over your shoulder about. Hallelujah. All right. Pray for the service tonight. Come back expecting God to do something in your family and in your life. Remember, on Tuesday night, ladies' night, Bible study, whatever you want to call it, Tuesday night at 6:30. Friday night, Bible study. Brother Johnny be teaching Bible study on how to study. Amen. Bible says study to show thyself approved. You need to read the Bible, but it is important to study the Bible. So he's going to teach us, amen, some great tools on how to do that. So that'll be this coming Friday night at 6:30 as well. Be doing that probably however he feels led, once, twice a month, whatever it is, he feels led to do it. And so get the word out. Anybody that wants to come to Bible study, be on Friday night. So ladies, 6:30 on Tuesday night, and come and expect God just to uplift you, amen, and be a part of that. Any other announcements I need to make? Youth choir practice at 5 o'clock this afternoon. So young people, come, be a part of that, and be a blessing to the church. Thank you, young people, for being faithful to God. Such a great group of young people we have. I do not take that for granted. Thank you. Live for God. Amen. Stand for God. Keep the devil at bay. Don't give in to his tactics.